I came from the bottom and now we is lit. You was lit. I gotta get it, I gotta get it. You hatin' cause I said no risk. My bitch, you wanna be famous, huh? The LA they made us, huh? You know I'm pricey in Vegas. This for the that hate us, huh? I make a lot of new money, huh? When the d not save us, huh? You be liking my flavor, huh? I think it's God. I said no risk. Call the rest. Call the rest. Watch out for that.
Ever since I blew, they out on my hey, back then, they know I exist. Don't touch my cup, you know how I sip. Hey, got your long that I made her when I showed out my whip. Hey, spent my 10 on my 50. Act slick, then hit with the back then, you out the zip. Blow out his back, then dip. Got a whole hole for the all on the ship. All these four things pull out the vip. Suck, turn up, baby, pour out the milk. So you know how I drip. Crush.
Just a spectacular afternoon for football here in the Tar Heel State of North Carolina as EA Sports welcomes you inside Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made the... Folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Dallas Cowboys and the Carolina Panthers. Fielded about a yard deep. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30.
Here we go, set, 60 Pittsburgh.
55 to Mike. Hey, watch the slant, watch
the
slant.
Ready?
The first carry now for Dalvin Cook. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
Looking to throw on second down. Morris, and that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Yeah, good game catching the ball out of the backfield a week ago, and they're going to try and involve him in that way in this game as well. But you can tell scouting is taking over. They're making it a little bit more difficult.
And defensively, they told us, hey, we've got to take him out of the passing game, limit it to just short runs, because he can really impact this offense.
That throw's not going to get them a whole lot, but that really didn't matter, did it? They got what they needed on that throw. Picked up the first down, and I'm going cliche here. Game of inches, partner.
Absolutely. Well, and you talked to me a lot about opening drives, how key those are to set the tone. You kept the drive alive. Third down conversion here is big. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. It's a Carolina first down on a gain of 16.
And there we see an early burst that makes him one of the leading rushers in the league.
I want you to know, I listened to you yesterday when we were watching film. You said write down the word vision for him. It was on display there, wasn't it?
It certainly was, because he allows the blocks to set up in front of him. And if that continues, it'll be a long afternoon for those guys trying to play some defense.
And he'll be brought down at about the 42. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
To throw on second down, Lawrence under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 46. And a sack by one of the most consistent D linemen in the game, Gerald McCoy. And on third down, the Cowboys bring in an extra defensive back. Back to throw. Lawrence. Screenplay. McKinnon. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. Fourth down now after a loss of 2.
I love the intelligence the defense just showed there. Read their keys, saw the screen developing, ran to it, and smothered it. What a third down stop by them.
And this is going to be ruled out, I think, just inside the 20. Yes, it will. Side judge calls it at the 19-yard line. They'll run it here. This is Marlon Mack. Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of 5.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second. A very solid gain on that play.
After the pickup of 5, here's second and 5. A first carry now. This is Alvin Kamara. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves them with a 3rd and 3.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
This one caught by Isabella. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. They have the first down with that gain of 4 yards. So 1st and 10 now from the 30. Now Martinez from the gun, he'll throw. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be 2nd down.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on 1st down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on 1st down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up 2nd down.
There's a throw over the middle. It's taken in by his tight end. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 13 yards and a 1st down, Cowboys. So 2 1st downs, and that moves the ball to the 42 now, 1st and 10. Operating from the gun, Martinez. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 43. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line. The rookie was trying to push it downfield, but the safety bit him.
And he'll learn that you have to hold the safety. And you do that with your head movement, your eyes, sometimes your shoulders. Hold the safety so that you can get back to the throw that you really want to make. He got so excited thinking his guy was open that he made it easy for the defensive back to go get the football.
Now a nice play defensively on 1st down as this is knocked away and incomplete. On 2nd down, Cook. And he's got this one across midfield into Cowboy territory. 9 yards on the pickup there as they'll be left with 3rd and 1. getting the sense Charles are going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, it's working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes nuts.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off near the 44. And his guys are going to get the football at their own 47-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
We're scoreless after one. Complete. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down.
And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense at every position. The tight ends have created so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time.
Backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. He lost two, and it brings up fourth.
Perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to free up their linebacker to get into the backfield and spill the play.
So on fourth down, here's Chris Jones to punt it away. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And this is a unit that, to be frank, doesn't look like they've woken up yet. I mean, a punt and a turnover on their first two drives.
And I think the game's starting to take shape a little bit now. And I'm going to take it to the basketball world. When you're having trouble scoring or moving the ball in basketball, what do? Get it to their best player, right? Find a matchup, create it, exploit it, and try to move the football.
Second and five. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And he'll get this from the 25 to the 30 for a pickup of five.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
They'll run it. Here's Cook. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. Got what he needed for the first down with a gain of two. I think you mentioned in the opening drive that these guys needed to establish the run, protect the young QB. I actually wrote that down, believe it or not. So how would you assess things so far?
I'm kind of touched that you actually wrote something like that down. I appreciate that, partner. But I do think they've been able to do that. Maybe not as effectively as they wanted to, but I think we'll see more of as this game goes along because they want to continue to take care of that young QB.
Give them 19 there as the drive marches forward. From the gun, Lawrence. He gets this one into the hands of Dalvin Cook. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, a ball may come your way.
4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. Second and six. Setting up the screen for Cook. He's got the first down here inside the 30. And he's got it all the way down to the 12-yard line. 33 yards that time. Not really any offense for them to speak of here in this first half. Maybe that's what they needed, that big play.
Yeah, it seems that maybe everything changes right there. They've been a little slow out of the gate. We've seen that. But that one big play, that could spark a big burst right here.
And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. That throw good for four. It's second down. 2 minutes on the clock in what's been a scoreless first half. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
Stepping up, he's going to keep it. He'll end up getting five out of that, but now they're looking at third down.
Now, how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
Hey, lock it. Check three, check three, check three. He's coming, he's coming, he's coming. We got double up, double up. Five.
And they'll let their fullback try and push the pile. And he takes it into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. It's the fullback with his first career NFL touchdown as his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon. Gano the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And now with still more than a minute to go in what's been a tight game, you figure we'll try to see them move the ball downfield.
And remember, they get the kickoff to start the second half, so this is a golden opportunity for them to go down there and put up a couple of sixes back-to-back. What a momentum swing that would be.
Yeah, you might be able to get a two-for-one without ever even giving up the football. First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Here we go on second and 12. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Looking to throw. Martinez. Into heavy traffic and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 32. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. Andy Isabella was the intended target.
You're trailing, you're trying to get points late in half. I absolutely understand that. But remember, it's all about the ball. And without the ball, you can't get those points. They just turned it over.
Now you got to be careful because that deficit can get a little bigger on the other side with that good field position they just took over with. That'll be complete to Cook. And some space here. That good for 21 yards on the catch and run. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 33 seconds to go in the first half. Second and four. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
When you got your backs in the shadow of your goal line, you've got to be physical in that situation because there's not a whole lot of space, not a lot of wild plays that can be run there.
It's put up or shut up time defensively. Nice job just to make sure they didn't complete it on that play. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. That'll back him up 2 yards and also bring up 4th. So they won't get a touchdown, but here's a chance to at least get 3 to end the first half. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. So a capper there to a pretty good first half.
And I love the way that they put a chokehold on the clock. and pretty much drained everything before they put the field goal on the board as they headed into the half.
And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Time here for likely one play, then off to the locker room, and they're going to have some adjustments to make.
They certainly will, and I think a lot of people are thinking to themselves, all right, take the knee, get out of here, regroup. But how will the head coach and his staff approach halftime? Will it be angry? Will it be clinical? Will they be calm? Will they just let it all out? Who knows? I'm going to be a fly on the wall for this one, though.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. So we reach halftime here in a 10-point game. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, the Panthers out in front, and they will get the football first. Second half action underway. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there, because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution? Or did they think just they were just bad plays to call?
Yeah.
We'll find out pretty quickly here if they felt they had something going. But they just...
Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9.
I think normally we would talk about this more with basketball players and football players, but let's adopt it in this case. He's a stat sheet stuffer.
Had the interception earlier, now a sack. But he just needs... And this turns into disaster. He's not going to get forward progress. That'll be a safety. And you know, the man who sat in my chair the last few years, he has a theory. These plays, these safeties, they're so rare. Maybe they should be worth more than 2, maybe 4 points.
I think he's got a great point. I really do, Brandon. But I would go ahead and up it to 6. I'm a former defender. Ooh. To me, that's like scoring a touchdown.
Easy now. I'll go 4. I don't know about 6.
Come on, come on. Come up to 6.
A lot of points. Trying to fire up that running game with Dalvin Cook. Only a couple there as he'll be brought down about the 28.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up, because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Off the play fake. Lawrence. They'll roll him out right. And this is Cook with a grab. And only able to get 2 here. Stopped at the 30.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Back to throw, Lawrence. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
It's easy to see when we review this that the ball needs to come out quicker, because if you don't throw it right on the break, you bring a crowd of people into the equation.
And that's why it got knocked away there. This is away, and a very good kick angled for the sidelines.
The Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 18-yard line.
Here we go. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And last time they surrendered the safety, we know they don't want to do that again.
That is just one of those oddities in scoring that we get. And it's just so strange to see that go up on the board. And then you've got to make sure that that doesn't happen to your team again. They've got to take care of the ball.
But boy, it juices up the defense.
Oh, without a doubt. That's a great way to score some points. How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
Here's second and eight. And that'll be incomplete. Good protection that time, and they couldn't hook up on the long one. Now it's third down. We have not seen a whole lot of wide open receivers. Everything seemingly has been contested.
And that's another nice job there to force an incompletion. They've been very quick.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter as he'll kick it away for the second time. His first punt, 48 yards. This one looks equally as good. And taken right on the 30. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. This crew had to punt last time they had the ball, but when you've got a lead like this, you content to play the field position game?
You are to an extent, especially if you like your defense, because you have the lead, you've been controlling the game. But why put them in a tougher spot? You want to get out there and get something done on offense and maybe take command of this game yourself.
Second and 13. And that going to be incomplete. A lot of contact, no call, and it's third down.
We've seen good cover skills on display throughout this game, really from both teams. And there's another nice example there of them making it difficult to complete a pass.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Looking to throw. Lawrence. Is this intercepted? It is. It's intercepted. Picked up by Mikel Roby Coleman. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. Third and long that time. He was trying to make something happen, but a little too risky.
Well, the field tilted on him. And what I mean by that is what you said. Third and long. Got to push it downfield to try and pick up the first down. Defensive backs live for this situation. And they took advantage of the young man right there.
Blitz coming, and down he goes. K1 short with a sack. That's 315 pounds of man right there.
Brandon, I think you understand the type of afternoon this offensive line is having. It is a long one for them. Long for you to spend it with me. Long for them trying to block those guys. They've given up a whole lot of sacks, and the speed and quickness that defensive line is eating them alive.
After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Back to throw. Martinez. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And this is going to wind up incomplete. The coverage there too strong on the deep ball, and now they face a third down. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. To throw is Martinez, operating from the gun. And that will be incomplete.
The one with the dive look that time on defense just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Averaging over 50 yards a punt so far as this one's away. ...51 yards on the punt there. And out will come the offense as they take over. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Second and 10. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked up by Leighton Vander Esch. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now three interceptions in this ballgame.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way?
Pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack. Darren Lee in there to record another sack, and that is now six on the afternoon for this defensive unit. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. Looking to throw. Martinez. Throwing right, and that's complete. A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for third down. Here's Martinez on third down. That's complete to his running back, Kamara. And this play going to be stopped in its tracks at the 32, and obviously well short of the first down. Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on four. And we're back now in Charlotte. It's the Cowboys in possession of the football, but they trail here as we begin the fourth quarter of play. Martinez now throwing on fourth down. Able to find Isabella. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down. Now Martinez on first and 10. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Marlon Mack, his fourth touchdown on the year, as his guys are back within a single score. And they're able to run it in. It started with a battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how are we going to slow down this running game, because on that particular play, they had no answer.
And it looks like the Panthers' hands team does its job. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team...
Taking it right down Broadway! Touchdown, Carolina! Curtis Samuel, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Panthers, they widen their lead. They have to love seeing that from their young quarterback here in the fourth quarter, able to further that lead with a touchdown pass.
He didn't go turtle, did he? And you know what I mean by that. I had an old coach used to say all the time, hey, when we have a lead late, don't just tuck in and try and ride it out. Go out and play and extend a lead. And that's what he did.
Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Martinez throwing on first down. Looking middle, and that's complete. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. An ideal beginning of the drive there as they'll get 20 and a first down. Back to throw. Martinez looking left side. He's got it complete. And this will be good for a pickup of 9 to the 46. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. Second and 1. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
And we just saw another example. These cornerbacks have played tight coverage all game long. Might start wanting to think about a few double, triple move routes to try and shake their guys free.
They have, you're right, they have had no room to breathe. And quick throw here, that's complete. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. They call his number again. It's his sixth catch and a first down. To throw is Martinez on first down. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
They went with a dime look on defense. Two extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
Here now is second and 10, again from the 41. To throw again, Martinez. And an alley to run. The Cowboys on third down. They've struggled to the tune of 2 for 8 so far. This time it's 3rd and 3. Looking to throw. Martinez. They'll set up the screen now to Kamara. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue. Clock management definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Darren Lee picks it, and he'll bring this one back to the 29. That time defensively looked like they showed quite a bit of pressure, but backed off, and it proved fruitful. They get the pick.
He went through all of his rules about getting rid of the ball quickly because he read blitz. He saw all those people stacked at the line of scrimmage, and then they fooled him by dropping into coverage. Now he's ready to get rid of the ball fast, but guess what? Too many defenders out there. Exactly as you described, an interception.
14 yards, good for a Panther first down. Good starting position for the Panthers as they come up 1st and 10 at their own 43. On the ground, it's Cook. Cook stripped, the ball's out. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And now off to the races, down the right side. And he will fight his way into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. On for the PAT, Kaimi Fairbairn. And this time he gets it to go as it is up and good. So here's the kickoff now as they'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And the decision to come out is going to cost him 5 as he's taken down right at the 20. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They'll be looking to make amends for the events of a moment ago. A fumble return for 6 points.
You absolutely have to protect the football. That's got to be priority number one because margin for error is starting to slip away. Now it's down to a one-score game.
They'll come up 2nd and 6 now from the 24. Off play action, Lawrence. And complete, right side to Cook. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. 9 yards the pick up there, and it's a first down. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the 2-minute warning. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up 1st and 10. On the carry, it's Cook. 11 yards and a Panther first down.
Now that's how you start to get back in the good graces of your head coach. Remember, he fumbled on the last possession. How about the faith they showed him, giving him the ball again, and he repaid him, picking up a first down.
And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. So 5 yards there as one of the big guys up front moved.
And in a 4-3 front, you've got the 2 defensive tackles right near the football. I know there's a lot of movement around there, but they're always taught to have one eye on the football. Apparently, that didn't happen.
The Cowboys going to use their 2nd timeout now. That'll leave them with just 1 remaining in this 4th quarter of play. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. They run, Cook. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be 3rd down.
And this is an absolutely big 3rd down that's been set up here, partner. And there's no other way to put it. The defense has to get a stop here if they have any hopes of winning this game.
Pastor, you said big 3rd down. I'd put the word big in capital letters here. Back to throw, Lawrence. And this is caught. He hits Moore. And he's going to have another 1st down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys' 38-yard line. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. That one looks like he'll throw here. Rolling to his right. And he's going to keep it here. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard. Another yard would probably put this thing in the books. It's 2nd and 1. Cook. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
So this one is over. A victory for Carolina. And you've got to say, CD, it was the defense who had a big part in the W.
Well, without question, when you force 4 turnovers, you get to enjoy the spoils of victory, don't you? It's rare that you force 4 turnovers and lose a ball game. That's almost unheard of. They carried this one home. You talk about celebrating with each other and being in a position where going forward, all you think about is, let's get 5 next time. They're going to be on the hunt.
So for the Panthers, they fall a game under .500 now at 3 up and 4 down.